Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to the online classes here at SMB Qaid-e Azam School. Our today's topic is distance and displacement, class 9th and matric. So here we'll talk about the distance and displacement. बात करेंगे हम distance और displacement की. So now we are going to talk about the distance and displacement here. So as we have here the starting point and the end point, whenever we start any distance from the starting point to the end point, if a man is walking from the starting point and it is walking through any way to come to the point which is the end point, so now this whole measurement is called the distance which is in front of you. But if we are going to take a shortest route, then it will be the displacement, as we have here given that. So now this is the displacement which is a shorter, which is clear and in one dimension and in one direction. Simple, we can say that the minimum distance and the measurement of length from the start point to the end point is called as the displacement. So simply it means that starting from the starting point, the lines which are showing here, which are giving here the distance, are shown by the blue lines here. So these are the lines for the distance, and the black line which is in a straightforward direction, these are called as the displacement, because displacement is a vector quantity. So for the vector quantity mostly it is used here. If we talk for the displacement or the distance, then what is the difference between the displacement and the distance? Actually, displacement is a one-dimensional motion, and distance is not a one-dimensional motion or in any particular direction. The motion of object is not in a particular direction, as you know that it is changing its direction way by way to reach to the end point. But if there was a shorter point, like there was the displacement, so it is only and only in a single direction here, no change in the direction to reach the end point. But on the other hand, you can see there that this is a displacement, at which this point there was a displacement, but here it is a distance which is in all over the direction here, changing its places and all the things. Okay, so I think you must here. And other example for the distance and the displacement, as you can see that here was the A point and the B point. If body is moving from the A point towards the B point, then there are the different three path one here, and then if body is moving with particular direction from the path two and from the path three, then now. So now here, if I'll ask that if we are at the point A and we are moving with a path 1, then is it in single direction or there was any particular direction? So no, the answer will be no. But in the second path, when body is moving from A point to B point, this is a straightforward way. So single path. So whenever the body is moving with the path 3, then it is also not in a particular path here. So in path 1 actually body is moving with a different directions, but in path 2 the body is moving with a straight line, and with path 3 again body is moving in a 2 or 3 directions here. It means we can say that there was no any particular direction in path 3 also, because it is changing. This is the point where it is changing the direction of its movement here. So simply we can say that what is the distance? Length of a path between two points is called the distance between those points. So this is the length which is in front of you. Whenever the body is moving with different directions to reach its destination or its point where it wants to reach, this is the arrow which shows the destination, but the blue line which is showing that how it is walking, how it is going to its destination. So what is the displacement? How far from the start point in a straight line? It means if a body is moving straight from one point to another point, as we have shown here the red line. So here red line is showing that the body is moving from the A point to the B point, and the path which is followed here, which is shown by the red color, this is the particular path. So displacement is the shortest distance between two points which has a magnitude and direction. As I have already told you that displacement has particular direction, displacement is a vector quantity. So furthermore we will talk about the vector quantities, that what are the vector quantities, but here the displacement is the vector quantity and distance is a scalar quantity. As it is a maximum coverage of the measurement of the length, so it is also the distance here which is given. So here it is the magnitude and the direction which is showing that it is in moving in a particular direction, means there is no any change in the direction. And magnitude here is the 1 kilometer, is how much amount of the length has covered, so it is called the magnitude here. As we have the 1 kilometer here, it means that body is covering the distance of 1 kilometer here. So the 1 kilometer, as it is called the magnitude of a substance, as substance are the quantity. So here we have the quantity which is the length, and length is measured into the meters and the kilometers, and the subunits are the other. So here is the kilometer, kilometer is the magnitude. So again it's in front of you that distance is a scalar quantity which does not have any particular direction, only magnitude. But the displacement is a vector quantity, means it requires not only the magnitude but it also requires the direction, particular direction. If there is any particular direction, then we can say that it is a vector quantity. But if there was no any particular direction, then it is called the scalar quantity. So distance is a scalar quantity, but the displacement is vector quantity. So how are the properties and the equation for the displacement? Displacement can be positive, negative or zero. Means if we are going to measure the displacement, we can say that it may be the positive, it may be the negative, or it may be the zero, means no any displacement, it may be, okay. So these are the points which you have to keep in mind, that displacement may be positive, displacement may be negative, or it may be the zero. So the question arises in your mind that what is about the zero displacement? It means if there was zero displacement, that there is no any displacement. So displacement is zero when you start and end at the same spot. Means if you are starting from a point and you are ending at the same point, it means your displacement is zero there. Furthermore, we will discuss these all the things in the examples. So here, displacement has 2 points, final position and the initial point. So displacement formula is the final position minus initial position. It means that there was a change in displacement, delta x is shown by the change, where f is for the final position and the I is for the initial position here. It means that a body is starting and going through any proper channel, through any distance displacement, so covering a displacement, then there was a change which is called as the delta x. It is in front of you, there was a change and it is called as a displacement which is there. So here are some examples in front of you. We are going to start from the 0 point to the 0.5. It means if we are going to start from A point to B point, the total coverage of the distance is from 0 to 5, not point but 0 to 5. So here we have displacement which is covered from the 0 point. It means you have to keep in mind that which is the starting point. Here is the starting point which is the 0 and it is the A point. Then we have the B which is the final point. So we have formula VXF here and XI. So XF means the final position B. So 5 minus 0 is the initial point. So what will be our displacement? Answer will be 5. Very good. So here is we have the answer which is 5. 5 is the answer which is a positive answer. It is the total measurement of the displacement along the path, along which is given path. So here again we are going to start from a point. Like we have the A point which is the initial point and it is moving towards the B point which is at the final point. So now here initial point is A and final point is B. So VF, on the VF position there will be 0. Whether on the position of the XF or VI, we will put here 5. So according to the formula, 0 minus 5, the answer will be minus 5. It means that it is covering its distance in the opposite direction. First the direction was from 0 point to 5 point, but here again it is moving from the, we can say that it's returning back. Whenever the direction is in the opposite direction, then the coverage will be in minus. So here was a change in the direction which is given in front of you, that whenever body is moving from A point which is the initial point towards of B point which is the final point here, which is the 0 to 5. But on the other hand, we have given here the displacement which is from the 5 to 0. So as a result of the positive direction, 5 meter which was given here from the A point to toward the B point, but now here as the body is moving from the 5 which is the B point, or it's moving from the opposite direction, the displacement will be in the minus negative point. So it means that we are getting the direction. So here if both are given in front of you, then it will be the 0 answer because there will be no any result. The final is, here we have another example from the A point to the B point. If a body is covering a displacement here which is from the initial point 0 towards the B point which is the 5, so according to the formula, what will be our answer? Answer will be the 5 as compared. But as we have the second point, so means second point, what is the minus 3 and the first point is initial point is 0, so our answer will be minus 3 meter here. Very good. So our answer will be minus 3, not 0, because it is moving from the 0 towards the minus point, because it is moving in the negative direction. So our answer will be the negative. And negative answer is minus 3 in front of you. I hope you have understood these all the examples, distance and the displacement well. So, Khuda Hafiz.